Okay. Welcome, my students. I'm Jenny Jimena Borges Rodriguez. I'm 44 years old. I'm from Convención Norte de Santander. Convención is near town de near my to Ocaña. Yes, I don't know that you listen of the this province. Okay. I have always lived like here, yeah. And my English teacher in the last grade, I always teach English, of course, in 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. Okay. And you, tell me, what is your name? Give me a moment because I shared the presentation, yes? Give me a moment and tell me that you can see the presentation. Oh, but come on, come on, come on. What happened here? Okay. And give me a moment because I shared the presentation. No, you can see the presentation. What happened here? Oh, okay. It's here. Amen. Tell me if you can see the presentation. Yes? Can you see the presentation, please, students? Tell me if you can see the presentation.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, my dear students. Okay. Now, you talk about your introduction. Yes. Please, it's necessary that you when you say the introduction. Keep in mind this question, yes? Keep in mind this question for doing the presentation, okay? Tell me, a ver, come on. Tell me, Edward, please, beginning.
Hello, tutora and compañeros. My name is Edward Fayán Camacho Giraldo. Yes. I am from Curo Maní Cesar. Year old, 28 old.
Yes. Continue. Please, Edward, can you see the presentation? Excuse me.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Do you have a job, Edward? Edward, tell me.
Tutora, tengo mala conexión, me estoy ubicando. Qué pena.
Okay, don't worry. Please tell me Natalia. Natalia, please introduce yourself, please. Natalia Correa.
Yeah, teacher.
Yes, beginning, please.
My name is Natalia Correa Mina. I'm from Santander de Quilichao. I am 18 years old. I am in the language course. List teacher.
Please. Tell me.
Hello.
Yes, I can listen well, please. No puedo escucharte, Natalia.
My name is Natalia Correa Mina. I'm from Santander de Quilichao. I am 18 years old. I am in the language course. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Are you married or single? Natalia. Natalia.
Sí, teacher.
Are you married or single?
Repeat.
Are you married or single?
No, no te entiendo, profe.
Si eres casada o soltera, are you married or single?
Soltera.
Oh, okay, single. I am single.
I
am single. Repeat, please. Okay. What do
I
you
am
do?
Single.
Okay. What do you like to do in your free time? What do you like? Tell me. Read, listen to music, watch movies. What have? What? Tell me.
To music.
Okay. What semester are you doing, Natalia?
Repeat.
What semester are you doing? Natalia, ¿qué semestre estás? ¿En qué semestre estás?
Three.
Okay, well, what topic would you like to learn in these courses? In this encounters, excuse me. Do you understand the question?
Repeat.
Natalia, what topic would you like to learn in these encounters? ¿Qué temas te gustaría que te reforzaran en estos encuentros? What topic? No.
No.
Okay, don't worry. Welcome, Natalie. Continue. Tell me. I listen. Okay, Sebastián Guerrero, please. Tell me. Begin, please.
Hello, partners and tutor. My name is Sebastián Guerrero. I am 26 years old. I study to English degree English. I am like to video games and see movies.
Okay. Where are you from, Sebastián?
I am from Bogotá, Colombia. I am from Colombia.
Okay. Watch movies. And watch movies and TV and games. Okay. Okay, welcome, Sebastián. Okay. Adriana. Adriana Antolinés. Please introduce yourself. Adriana, you tell me, you listen me.
Hello.
Hello, Adriana. Please tell me. Begin in
my
introduction.
Adriana Carvajal.
Sí, yeah.
I from my
sí.
Hello, my name is Adriana Antolina Carvajal. I'm from Malaga, Santander. I am 25 years old.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Are you single or married? Adriana, are you single or married? Do you have children or no? Do you or don't have children? What? Tell me.
Hello.
Okay. Are you married or single? No. ¿Me entiendes la pregunta, Adriana? Adriana. Okay, continue. Follow the clues. Kelly, tell me.
Good afternoon. Listen to me.
Yes.
Okay. My name is Luz Kelly Otero Guerrero. I am from San Marcos, Sucre. I am live in Puerto Asís, Putumayo. I am 21 year old. I work in primary school. ¿Qué más? I am in for semestre o bachelor.
¿Cómo? ¿What? O bachelor. Hola. Okay.
Hola.
I am for semestre bachelor. Hello. Of the foreign language with emphasis in English.
Yeah.
I like dance, work, study, and sleep. I am engaged. I am happy, keen, hardworking, collaborating. Also, I be cranky and jelly.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Welcome, Kelly, Luz Kelly. Very good. Okay, please, thank you. Pay attention. And now it's very important that you have what is the rule for these encounters, yeah? Beginner, be on time, yeah? Sign in the at least 10 minutes before class. Please be prepared, all your things must be prepared before joining the class. Turn on the camera, yeah, always turn your camera on so we can see each others. Don't forget, okay, yes, it's very important when you talk or when you speak, please turn on the camera, okay? Enjoy learning. I hope that you like this class, these encounters, yes? Let's enjoy these new kinds of learning. Please mute your microphones when you are not talking, yeah? Raise your hand, talk or ask teacher for help, yeah? And obviously, be respectful online, okay? Well, for beginners, this class, the first class, I need that you listen a short conversation. Yes, you have be too attentive, to be attentive, and write down the missing words in this conversation. ¿Sí? ¿Me están entendiendo lo que vamos a hacer? Por favor, me explican, me dicen cómo se sienten, si les hablo todo el tiempo en inglés o mejor hablar un poquito hablado en inglés y otro poquito hablado en español. Los escucho, por favor.
Hola, teacher.
Sí, tutora.
Pues, perdón. Personalmente, sí, pues, me gustaría que de pronto sí, como que se fueras hablando en inglés, pero también un poquito de pronto en el español, porque hay muchas palabras que son, de, pues, son desconocidas y a veces queda como difícil entender toda la idea. Entonces, pues, personalmente, ¿no?
Ok, listo. Don't worry. Me decía Sebastián o Edward, no sé, ¿alguien quería hablar más? Por favor, tell me.
Sí, tutora, soy Edward. Pues sí, como dice la compañera, pues muchas palabras a veces no lo entendemos o a veces queremos responder y respondemos a otra cosa, entonces,
pues sí. Yes, don't worry. Ok, cuando ustedes no entienden, do you know where está, please? Raise your hand and beginning the say the situation, okay? Empiezan a decir la situación. Okay, in this part, I say again, in this part, you listen the audio, yes? Audio, o sea, van a escuchar un audio, listen the audio, and you write down. Write down es tomar nota, ¿sí? Write down, se los voy a escribir acá que es un verbo frasal. Me regalan un segundo. Give me a moment. Insertar. I don't know that you show that you know this verse. Write down. Yes. Write down es tomar nota. Do you know this verse? Is it that verb? Frasal verb. Esto es un verbo frasal, muy usado, ¿no? Ok. Me gustaría que empezaran a tomar nota para que aprendieran cositas y no se queden en el aire. Ok. You write down the missing words in the conversation. ¿Ya? Ustedes van a tomar nota de cuáles son las palabras que hacen falta in this conversation. Ok. Do you understand me? ¿Me entiendes?
Yes.
Ok, beginner. Please. Tell me,
yes,
if you listen the conversation, yes? Okay, me dicen si escuchan la conversación, por favor.
Tell me about your morning routine.
After I get up, I always go jogging.
What do you do after that?
After that, I go to work. I'm a teacher.
Okay, please, can you listen well the conversation?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Okay. Can you understand the idea? ¿Pudieron entender la idea?
Yes, teacher.
Tell me. Is necessary that you listen again the audio?
Yes, repeat, please.
Okay, don't worry. And give me a moment because I don't. Esperen un segundo que no quisiera que les hiciera estorbo acá. Okay. Okay, listen again, please.
Tell me about your morning routine.
After I get up, I always go jogging.
What do you do after that?
After that, I go to work. I'm a teacher.
Okay. Please, Edward, tell me what is the first word that you listen in this part for complete the conversation. Can you listen? ¿Pudiste escucharla o no?
Yes, sí.
Cuéntame. Tell me. What is the first? Tell me about your, what is the depression?
Trata como de una conversación.
Sí, pero no, lo que te pido, lo que te estoy pidiendo es cuál es la palabra o la frase que hace falta para completar aquí esta conversación, Edward, ¿sí? ¿Cuál es esa palabra que falta? Voy a volver a colocar el audio y ustedes van a estar pendientes de cuál es esa palabra que hace falta para completar en la conversación. ¿Okay?
¿Ok?
Pay attention here.
Tell me about your morning routine.
After I get up, I always go jogging.
What do you do after that?
After that, I go to work. I'm a teacher.
Okay. Yes? Okay, tell me, Edward. What is the expression that is necessary right in this part of the conversation? ¿Cuál es la palabra o la frase necesaria para completar esta conversación? According to the audio, okay? De acuerdo a al audio. No? ¿No entendiste? Okay, give me... Don't worry. Give me, please. Natalia, please, tell me. What is the correct word? Natalia? What happened with Natalia? Oh, Natalia se salió. Okay. Tell me, entonces, digamos, follow with Sebastián, please, tell me. What is the correct word?
The first is morning routine.
Yes, very good. Morning routines. Morning routines, very good. Okay. And the second idea.
Jogging.
Jogging is similarly running. Run.
Yes.
Yeah? Jogging. Yes, so that. Okay. And finally.
Go to work.
Go to work. Very good. Go to work. Very good. Okay, pay attention to the other partners. Okay, vamos a escuchar the second conversation. Yes? Please pay attention. Write down. Yes, tomemos nota, por favor. What is the expression or what is the word that is necessary right for complete this conversation? Okay? Please, beginning.
What do you do after you get up, Tom?
I have breakfast, then go to school.
Do you walk to school?
No, I always take a bus.
Okay. ¿Es necesario listen again the conversation? ¿Es necesario escucharla nuevamente?
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Don't worry.
What do you do after you get up, Tom?
I have breakfast, then go to school.
Do you walk to school?
No, I always take a bus.
Okay. Please tell me, Luz Kelly, please. Give me.
Teacher, pues creo que alcancé a entender. Pues voy a intentar aquí.
No importa.
La primera es Befres.
A ver, the verb, the collocation o the verb complete words, what is, ¿cuál es la palabra?
Desayuno, completa? Desayuno.
Sí, pero en inglés, ¿cómo se diría? In English, what do you say? Perfect. Have breakfast. Have breakfast. Pay attention. Have. Okay.
Okay.
Continue. What is the other?
The second, creo que decía, do you work to school?
Work. ¿Será work o qué otra palabra sería? A ver, Edward, tell me. ¿Qué palabra tú estás haciendo? Are you listening? Edward? ¿Qué palabra le alcanzaron a escuchar, Edward? O Sebastián, please.
The second is go to.
Go to. Okay.
To the school.
A ver, oh. Whoa, bueno, pay attention, listen again the conversation, yes?
What do you do after you get up, Tom?
I have breakfast, then go to school.
Do you walk to school?
No, I always take a bus.
Okay. Okay, excuse Sebastian, me. Tell me.
Walk.
Walk. Sí, ojo
walk.
Que la L al pronunciarla es muda, es a letter, silent letter, es una letra silenciosa cuando está en este caso, ¿no? Walk. Do you walk to school? To school. Okay. A ver, Luz Kelly, tell me. What is the other question, the other word? It's very easy. No, I always take
a bus.
Yes, a bus. Very good. Yes. Okay. Well, tell me. This is a role play. The Mars facts, please. Edward and beginner. Edward and continue. Sebastian. Okay. Van a leer la conversación. You read the conversation. Sebastian beginning beginning Edward and follow Sebastian. Okay, Sebastian. Okay, beginner Edward, please read the conversation.
Please,
Edward.
Yes.
Okay. Empieza a leer la conversación. Tell me about your morning routine, John. O Sebastián, como tú lo quieras decir. Rapidito.
El mío en barrio.
Your morning routines, John. O Sebastián. Ok, Sebastián, continue.
After I get up, I always going jogging.
Ok. Edward, please. Edward. Okay, continue.
Tengo transferencia.
Okay, Edward. Oh, yeah. What do you do after that, Sebastian?
After that, I go to work. I am a teacher.
I go to work and my teacher. And my teacher. Okay. This is a linking. Se hace un linking. ¿Saben qué es un linking? Que se une la, se conecta la M con la A y decimos ANMA. O sea, se dice pega. ¿Sí? Eso se llama linkings. Okay, continue. Luz Kelly begin the conversation, the second conversation, and Edward continue. Okay. O sea, Luz Kelly is an interview and Edward is a tone. Okay, tell me, beginning the Luz Kelly, please.
Okay, what do you do after you get out, Tom?
I am my teacher.
Yes. I have breakfast, then go to school. Dice la parte de este, Edward.
Repite,
señor. I have breakfast, then go to school.
And I breakfast.
Breakfast. Breakfast. Que suene la T. I have breakfast, then go to school.
And I okay. Perfect.
Tengo yes, to school. School. Okay. School. Continue, Luz Kelly.
Do you walk to school?
Do you walk to school? Tom, Edward, please. Edward. No, I always take a bus. Edward. No, I always take a bus. Okay. Okay. De Kelly, Luz Kelly, I say, no, I always take a bus. Okay, continue. Tell me, Sebastian, what are topics of this conversation?
What do you do after you get up, Tom?
Ok, ¿me entiendes la pregunta? ¿Qué tópicos, qué temas tú ves hay en esta conversación? ¿Qué alcance, qué tema podemos deducir de aquí de estos listenings o de estas conversations?
¿The daily routine?
Yes, the daily routines. What other topics can you see?
Profession, maybe.
Profession, yes, yes. Okay, presence importance, yes or no? Okay.
Yes.
Okay, continue. Well, the topics for 2 days, as you can see in the presentation, is personal introduction and personal interest, yeah? When you say personal interest, you say the daily routines, yes? In this part, you, it's necessary that you practice the pronunciation, yes? Okay. Sebastian, read the first daily routines. Continue, Luz Kelly, the second routines, yes, la segunda fila, and Edward says the third daily routines, okay, la segunda fila, okay. Please tell me, beginning Sebastian, do the laundry, tell me, dímelas, por favor.
Do the laundry, hang the clothes.
Do laundry. Uh-huh.
Iron the clothes.
Clothes. Iron
clothes.
The clothes.
The clothes.
Yes.
Vacuum the floor. Make my bed.
Make my bed. Yes. Vacuum. Vacuum. Vacuum.
Vacuum
the floor. Okay. Vacuum the floor. Continue, Luz Kelly, please.
Go to bed. What?
Wake up. ¿Cómo?
What up?
Wake. Pay attention. Wake up.
Wake up.
wake up. Una hace el linking. Tú sabes que la E es muda, ¿verdad? Entonces uno dice wake yes. up. Se conecta. ¿Sí?
Okay.
Se conecta el wake. Se hace uno el link. Espérate un segundo.
Wake up.
Wake up. ¿Listo?
Ok.
Wake up. Se une y se dice rapidito, wake up. Ok, continue.
Wake up. Brush your teeth.
Brush your teeth. Brush your teeth.
Brush your teeth.
Brush your teeth.
Brush your teeth.
Okay, continue.
Try to work.
Try to work. Yes.
Get home.
Get home. Edward, please tell me. Edward. Edward, please. Okay, continue, Sebastian. Sebastian, please help me. Ayúdame.
Yes.
Okay.
Take a bath.
Take a bath. Sí, take a. Se hace el linking aquí también. Take a bath. Se hace, pronuncia así todo pegadito. Take a. Take a bath.
Bath. Okay.
Take a bath. Okay. Continue.
Brush your hair.
Brush. No brush, como están en A1, brush, como entre una O y una U, sí, brush your teeth, your hair, excuse me, brush your hair.
Brush your hair.
Ok, continue.
Surf the net.
Surf the net.
Play with friends.
Yes.
Go to school.
School. To school, no. To school. School. Go to school.
To school.
School. School, no. Que termine en una U, no. School. Oh, school. School. Como una O y una O suave. Una O y una suave. School. Ok. Very yes. good. Continue. Luz Kelly, please, beginning. Beginning the second... Daily routines, okay? Luz Kelly.
Okay. Go shopping. Exercise.
Yes. Exercise.
Makeup. Wash the.
That is put on makeup.
Put on makeup.
Un para que. Escuche como más americano, porque ustedes saben que lo más cercano que tenemos que aprender es el americano, pero también hay que aprender el británico, ¿no? Entonces, los americanos muchas veces la T la pronuncian como R. Entonces, aquí podríamos decir put on makeup, ¿sí? Para no decir put on makeup, no, put on makeup. También lo podemos decir así, put on makeup, ¿ok?
Ok, put on makeup. Wash the car, get dressed.
Ok. Sebastián.
Teacher, tengo una pregunta. Sí. Cada vez que digamos, termina una palabra en consonante y venga una vocal, ¿ahí se hace la unión de las dos palabras o solo hay en
sí,
ocasiones?
Sí, cuando no, casi siempre. Casi siempre, por lo menos aquí decimos put on makeup, wash the car, se escucha, no se dice wash the car, no, wash the car, se pronuncia todo. Aquí go out, por lo menos aquí es como, hay dos vocales, no se ve tanto, pero por lo menos aquí go for a walk. Aquí la R se conecta con la A y se hace. Eso es lo que llamamos linking. En pronunciación se llama linking eso. Y para que se escuche como más fluido, ¿ya? Con ese fin se hace. ¿Listo? Ok. Muy buena pregunta, Luz Kelly. Continue, Sebastián. go out with friends? Sebastián?
Go out with a friend?
Go out with a friend. Exacto. With a friend. Okay, continue.
Take pictures.
Yes.
Play the guitar.
Yes.
Water the plant.
Water. Los británicos creo que dicen es water. Water the plant. Water or water. Si vamos a hablar británico es water. Si es como americano, water. Water the plant. Okay.
Water the plant. Okay.
Okay.
Go for a walk.
Walk, no me pronuncies la L. Don't say walk. Walk. La L es muda acá, no suena. For a walk. Go for a walk. ¿Cómo va, Sebastián?
Go for a walk.
Eso. Very good. Continue. Okay. Vale. Congratulations. Edward, please. Help me. Ayúdame. Practice the pronunciation with these daily routines. Edward, tell me. Edward, por favor. Ay, Edward, se me quedó solito. ¿Me escuchas, Edward?
Tengo corto, escucha entrecortado, sí, tengo daily routine.
Bueno, okay, don't worry. Ayúdame, Luz Kelly, please.
Okay, teacher. Has breakfast.
Has breakfast. Pay attention. Espérate que yo aquí comparta cámara, pantalla grande, cómo se comparte. Have. Yo no sé si ustedes me están viendo allá completo, ¿sí? Have. Recuerden que la B se pronuncia have, que el labio, los dientes alcancen a tocar, a morder el labio inferior, ¿sí? Have breakfast. Breakfast. Have breakfast. ¿Yes? Have breakfast. Continue.
Have breakfast. Have lunch. Dinner.
Yes.
Make dinner.
Okay, very good. Well, pay attention here. When you say a daily routine, sometimes it's necessary use the to before. ¿Sí? Okay, remember. Remember the to before. Yes, it's necessary that you the structure, the force, the to be is an for the personal pronouns I is when use when the personal pronouns he, she, and it are with the personal pronouns you, we, and they. Okay, when you talk about some expression in affirmative, the structure is subject plus to be, in this case, an, is, or are, and plus complement. Yes? For example, when you say I am Mexican or I am from Mexico, he's Korean or he's from Korea. Yes? They are New Zealanders. Or they're from the New Zealand, yeah? When you say some expression in negative force, yes, it's necessary that you remember that the first part in this structure is subject, verb to be, and not, and continue with the complement. For example, when you say, I am not Canadian, or I'm not from Canada, yes? She's not Japanese, or she's not from Japan, or she isn't Japanese, yes? Or when you say we are not Australian, or we are not from Australia, or we aren't Australian, yes? This in this part show the old is a force when you say negative force, negative sentence, okay? And interrogative sentence, remember that you begin with the verb to be, yeah? And is or are plus subject and plus complement with the sign, okay? Con el signo de interrogación. For example, when you see an I American or is the panda from China, it is Asian or are you European and so on, yes? This structure is for to be, yes? But when you talk about a talk expression with other pairs, ¿sí? O sea, ustedes cuando van a decir expresiones en presente simple con otros verbos, it's necessary that you review or that you keep in mind, what is the rules? ¿Cuáles son esas reglas para esos otros verbos diferentes al de to be? Sí, diferentes de verbs to be. Okay, pay attention. For example, the rules general, la regla general is that the verbs you add s. Sí, a los verbos se les agrega la s. For example, when you say like, yes. Like, you add s, yes? When the verbs ending in a consonant y, pay attention here, the y changes by I, yes? And you add s. Si ustedes cambia la doble I, la I por I latina, y tú le agregas, si ustedes le agregan la s. For example, when you say cry, cries, yes? The verb ending in O, SX, X, CH, SH, XF, XH, perdón, excuse me. You add ES, yes? You add ES. For example, when you say go, goes. Miss, misses. Mix, mixes. Wash, washes. Watch, watches. Ojo acá al sonido, wash, watch, es más rudo este, ¿no? And the other irregular verbs, they change the word. For example, when you say go with the verbs to have, yes? Have or has, and the verbs be, that you know, is, and, are, okay? This is the rules for the verbs in present simple, okay? When do you have to add this suffix? ¿Cuándo ustedes tienen que agregar estos sufijos? ¿Sí? La S y la S. Ok, pay attention here. Well, in affirmative form, ¿sí? Remember when you talk about the personal pronouns I, you, we, and they, you had the verbs in normally. ¿Sí? Ustedes usan el verbo normalmente, ¿sí? I speak, you speak, we speak, or they speak. But when you have to talk about the third personal pronouns as he, she, and it, you have to use the rules, ¿sí? Cuando ustedes van a hablar acerca de las terceras personas, entonces, como he, she, it, entonces ustedes que tienen que usar la regla de las terceras personas. Ahí es a donde hay que aplicarla, ¿sí? Entonces, ojo acá. For example, when you say I speak English, he speaks Spanish, they live in London, she lives in Paris, yes? It's important that the third person verb need the final is in affirmative sentence, okay? Es o is, ¿no? But when you have to say negative situation, cuando ustedes van a decir alguna situación negativa in present simple, what happened? You have to use the auxiliar. Ustedes tienen que usar el auxiliar. What is the auxiliar? El don't and el doesn't, okay? when you have to use don't or doesn't, pay attention, okay? Pay attention here. You have to use don't when you use the third, the personal pronouns I, you, we, and they. Cuando ustedes tienen que utilizar el, los pronombres I, you, we, they, you have to use don't. And next, the verb. Y seguidamente, el verbo in forma in normal. Not, you can add, ¿sí? You can add the infinitive form. No pueden agregarlo en forma infinitiva. O sea, con to go, to need, to speak, to lick. No, it's incorrect. It's a big error. Yes? Ustedes le quitan el to y lo colocan normal. Go, need, por lo menos I go, I, you need, we speak, they live, and so on, yeah? But when you talk about the third person, the singular person pronouns, de las terceras personas del singular, as he, she, and it, como estos, ¿sí? As he, she, and it, you have to use the auxiliar doesn't, yes, doesn't, and next, the verbs. For example, when you, he speaks, she speaks, she needs, it likes, ¿sí? Se les agrega la regla, y que aquí, perdón, estamos utilizando es la negativa, ¿sí? Entonces, como aquí ya no se utiliza, no se utiliza la regla de la ES. Why? ¿Por qué? Because you have to use the auxiliar, porque ustedes están usando el auxiliar, ¿ok? Ojo con eso. Como ya tenemos el auxiliar, aquí la regla de la S o la S sobra, no se aplica, ¿listo? Look at the examples, ¿sí? I speak Spanish in affirmative. En negative, I don't speak Spanish. Aquí no hay ningún problema porque el verbo no cambia. Pero aquí sí, look at here. She speaks Italian. Italian, yes? Aquí, please, you can say in negative, she doesn't speak Italian, ¿sí? She doesn't speak Italian. Ojo acá, aparece el auxiliar con la negación y el verbo no se le aplica la S porque ya está el auxiliar que fortalece la forma negativa, ¿sí? Continue. With the question, what happened? With the question, for example, here, do you, when you be asked the question, have to use the auxiliar at the beginner sentence, ¿sí? Do I like or do you like, ¿sí? Or does she like or does he like? Or simplemente, does he speak? O does, o it needs. O when you say, si ese es el caso de do we needs o do we speak, and so on. ¿Listo? Bueno, cuando vamos a hacer oraciones interrogativas, when you have to use interrogative, the question with WH, con las palabras interrogativas, as when, where, how, why, and so on, son muchas, ¿no? ¿Qué pasa? You have kept in mind this structure, WH, auxiliar, do or does, plus subject, plus frequency adverb, and plus main verb, ¿ya? For example, when you say, what time do you usually go to class, ¿yes? Entonces, pay attention here. The answer, you can say yes or no. No le pueden utilizar yes or no. You have to say direct answer, direct answer, una respuesta directa. As you can say, I usually go class at 8 o'clock. Okay? Look at when you have to use the daily routines. Also, you have the kid in mind, adverbs of frequency, ¿sí? Ustedes tienen que recordar, ¿sí? O tener en cuenta los adverbios de frecuencia. Remember that the adverbs, frequency adverbs are used to say how often do you something or something happens. ¿Sí? Tenemos que, para mirar con qué, para mirar a ver, con, lo utilizamos para mirar a ver con qué frecuencia nosotros hacemos las cosas. Ok, the frequency adverbs, ¿sí? O the adverse frequency, in this chart, show the high frequency to low frequency, for example, always, o sea, siempre, usually, usualmente, normally, or generally, often, or frequently, sometimes, occasionally, ¿sí? Occasionally, seldom, hardly ever, rarely, and never. Pay attention here. Seldom, hardly ever, or rarely, or never. Y son, se podrían tomar como interpretaciones negativas, ¿sí? Como que casi no se usan. Entonces, ¿qué pasa? Cuando utilizamos el never, nosotros, si nosotros vamos a utilizar que nunca, nosotros no podemos usar el doesn't o el don't. Si vamos a decir que no tiene, que nunca hace eso, pues no agregamos el don o el doesn't, sino decimos never. Por lo menos, cuando yo digo, I never go to the gym, yo nunca voy al gimnasio, ¿sí? Entonces, I never go to the gym. O simplemente yo digo, I don't go to the gym, yo no voy al gimnasio. O utilizo el never, o utilizo el don, o utilizo el doesn't. Pero el never con el do, con el auxiliar, nunca va. ¿Quedó claro? Bueno, what is the ubication?
Teacher.
Dime, mi amor.
O sea, cuando se utilizan los, siempre que se utiliza cualquier adverbio, nunca se utiliza el auxiliar, ¿cierto?
No. Te estoy hablando es del never solamente, Luz Kelly. ¿Sí?
Okay.
Por eso te pongo el ejemplo. Mira, te voy a copiar acá, voy a colocar aquí un ejemplo para que me lo veas es, y se vea, ¿sí? Por lo menos tú colocas acá, ¿sí? El que yo te acabo de decir, I never go to the gym, ¿sí? Yo nunca voy al gimnasio. Esa es una acción. Eso es lo mismo que decir, I don't go to gym, to the gym, ¿sí? Es lo mismo. Pero lo que tú nunca puedes hacer sería un gran error esto. Espérate. Ay, ¿qué pasó acá? ¿Lo borré? No. O sea, sería un gran error que tú me dijeras esto. I don't never go to the gym. Esto sí está mal dicho. Esto no se puede hacer. ¿Listo?
Sí, no, lo que de pronto es que, o sea, por lo menos cuando se va a utilizar al why o usually, siempre se utiliza la misma regla, o sea, digamos, el does y el do no se utiliza, o sí, pues,
se puede utilizar. Sí, se puede utilizar, sí. Sí, yo puedo, aunque una tutora me decía, casi no es como normal decir, yo no siempre voy al colegio. Uno en español lo utiliza adverbios de frecuencia y la expresión negativa. En inglés también se usa, pero no es tan común, no es muy usual, ¿sí? Por lo menos, pero porque es que se escucha raro, por lo menos si tú dices, I don't go to the gym. Yo no rara vez voy al cole, al gimnasio. ¿Sí te das cuenta que se escucha rarísimo? Sí, pero entonces, pero sí se puede usar, por lo menos es muy escaso, pero siempre se utiliza para oraciones afirmativas, interrogativas, pero para negar casi no se utiliza. Si se utiliza es muy remota la idea, ¿no? Sí, me hago entender. Por lo menos esto aquí es un grave error. Nunca puedes utilizar el don't y el never. O utilizas el never o utilizas el don't. ¿Quedó claro? ¿Sí me hago entender?
Sí, teacher, lo que pronto es que usted no me ha comprendido la idea. En la diapositiva número 9 usted tenía un ejemplo. En la parte de abajo aquí dice, usually go to class at o'clock. Entonces, donde yo tenía la inquietud, o sea, estoy utilizando el adverbio usual. Entonces, ahí no entraría el do, o siempre se cumple la regla de que no entra el auxiliar.
Luz Kelly, mi amor, mira, aquí estás usando una respuesta afirmativa. Y para dar una respuesta afirmativa, tú puedes usar el auxiliar que tú quieras, el adverbio de frecuencia que tú quieras. ¿Ya me hago entender? Aquí, por lo menos, aquí estamos dando, pues yo siempre, que yo usualmente voy a clases a las 8 de la mañana, a las 8 en punto, ¿sí? Este uso me está indicando la frecuencia que tú lo haces. Si tú colocas el do acá, sería incorrecto porque tú para hacer oraciones afirmativas no utilizas el auxiliar, el do, el don. Utilizas el do y el don, el don't, o el do y el das para hacer oraciones negativas y para hacer oraciones interrogativas. No para hacer oraciones afirmativas. ¿Sí me estás entendiendo?
Ah, okay. Sí, señora, sí. Ya.
Vuelvo y te repito, Luz Kelly. El do se utiliza, el do y el does se utiliza, you have to use in negative and interrogative questions, no more. For affirmative, para las oraciones afirmativas, no utilizas ni do ni does. Lo que sí tienes que tener en cuenta es las reglas de las terceras personas, pero cuando tú vas a trabajar el he, el she, el it, that is, es decir, el the third person, las terceras personas. ¿Estamos claras?
Sí, teacher, estaba confundida. Ya caí en cuenta.
No, pero eso es bueno. Gracias. Que preguntes y que despejes la duda, ¿ok? Eso está muy bien. Ok, what is the structure when you have to use, don't worry, when do you have to use the frequency adverb? Ok, pay attention. Hannah always eats lunch at the school. ¿Sí? Lunch at the school. Ok, Hannah usualmente, perdón, siempre come almuerza en el colegio. ¿Sí? Lucas, Hannah is a subject, follow frequency adverbs, and the verb is follow the adverbs. ¿Qué quiere decir esto? Pay attention, que the frequency adverb is between the subject and the verb. El adverbio de frecuencia se coloca en medio del sujeto y en medio de, entre el verbo, ¿sí? No se coloca ni antes del sujeto ni después del verbo, sino en la mitad, en medio del sujeto y del verbo que se está hablando, ¿listo? Pero what happened with to be? ¿Qué sucede con la forma del verbo to be? Aquí sí la cosa nos cambia, ¿sí? Pay attention. Hannah is always happy. ¿Qué sucede? Que the frequency adverb go after the to be. Aquí sí se toca que colocarlo después. El verbo en los verbos normales diferentes al verbo to be va before, va antes, mejor dicho para que me entiendan. Y con el verbo to be va después, va go after. ¿Quedó claro? Eso sería también importante tenerlo en cuenta. ¿Ya? Yo no puedo decir Hannah always is happy. No, no lo puedo hacer, eso es incorrecto. Tengo que decir Hannah is always happy. ¿Ya? ¿Cuál es la palabra interrogativa que me marca a mí la frecuencia? Ok, pay attention. How often es la palabra interrogativa que me muestra la frecuencia. O sea, ¿con qué frecuencia? How often do you go to class? How often do you go to class? ¿Con qué frecuencia tú vas al colegio? Entonces, I usually go to class. Yo usualmente voy al colegio. O you always go, I always go to class. I never go to class. Yo nunca voy al colegio, ¿sí? It's depending, ¿ok? Well, continue. Pay attention here. ya vamos a terminar lo que es la presentación, la explicación de los temas. When you have to talk about the daily routines, or when you have to write the daily your daily routines, it's necessary that you use the connectors. What is the connectors that is necessary that you have keep in mind, tengan en cuenta para write, para describir o para decir una rutina diaria? Pues los conectores que son frecuentes para decir una rutina diaria son the times or in sequence and the connectors, addition connectors, okay? What is the sequence connectors? Miremos a ver, tenemos later, tenemos after, tenemos before, tenemos then, next, soon, finally, first, second. Esos son los más usuales, ¿no? Y en addition, los conectores de adición, tenemos as well as, que es el mismo, el also, son sinónimos. Also, y aquí lo tenemos also, y as well as is the same. Sí, son signos y similars, ¿ok? También puede significar además, ¿no? Además de así como el as well as. And, también tenemos a to, tenemos a furthermore, ¿sí? Ese furthermore is the same as moreover, y significa también además. Tenemos in addition to, ¿sí? Not only, but also, nor. Yes, esos son los más usuales para tenerlos en cuenta en una de rutina diaria. And now I share the examples. Voy a presentarles un ejemplo de un daily routines, okay? Pay attention. Please tell me that I share the presentation. Okay. Give me a moment. Okay. Give me a moment because I share what is dejar de compartir. Me voy para acá. Ahora sí. Me avisan si pueden escuchar el audio, ¿ok? Porque el video tiene sonido. Ok, pay attention and listening.
Renee is 35 and she's...
¿Sí escuchan algo o no?
Yes, teacher.
Ok, very good. Ay, no quiero... Ok. Ouch. Esperen que me lo inicie otra vez.
We all know the crazy chaos caused by trying to use more than one app for productivity.
Okay, disculpen que me metí mal acá. Ah, bueno, ok.
Renee is 35 and she's a writer. She lives in a small flat in London. She lives with her two dogs and a cat. She wakes up late at 10 o'clock in the morning. She has coffee and a sandwich for breakfast. After breakfast, she goes jogging. After she comes home, she works in her home office until 6 o'clock in the evening. She never has lunch, but she always eats a big dinner. She often invites friends over and cooks dinner for them. After dinner, she usually watches TV or reads a book. She goes to sleep at midnight. At weekends, she visits her parents in Manchester.
Bueno, okay. Can you see the presentation? Yes. Yes or no?
Yes.
¿Vieron el ejemplo? Okay. Aquí nos muestran la frecuencia con que se hacen las cosas. Aquí ella se muestra cómo se la secuencia, el orden con que se dicen las cosas es importante. Eso es, hay que tener un orden lógico de decir las cosas y la frecuencia con que las hace. Sí, mirar a ver si se utiliza la regla de la SOS, cómo se pronuncia. También ustedes deben tener en cuenta la forma como, si se utiliza el verbo to be o no, o el verbo normal en presente simple y así por el estilo, ¿no? En este momento vamos a hacer un ejercicio. Me están viendo la pantalla, ¿verdad? Ok.
Yes.
Ustedes van a mirar, bueno, ustedes me van a decir cuál es el verbo apropiado para completar el texto. Ok, pay attention here. E iniciamos. Beginner es Luz Kelly. Me continúa Sebastián. No sé si Edward podrá colaborarnos, participar, porque las otras dos chicas se salieron. Entonces miremos a ver. Ok, pay attention here. Ok.
Teacher. ¿Qué hago?
Dime.
No, a mí no me aparece nada en la pantalla.
No, entonces listo, don't worry, ya te comparto. ¿Quién me habló? Discúlpame, ¿me habló Luz Kelly o Natalia?
Natalia.
Ay, Natalia, estás aquí. Yo pensé que te habías ido, Natalia, qué pena.
No, teacher.
Ah, bueno, entonces listo, menos mal, porque yo hacía cuentas de que te habías ido. Me preocupaba porque ustedes saben que estas clases son evaluables, ¿no? Bueno, entonces, listo, voy aquí a compartir. ¿Sí lo ven? Ok. Bueno, Natalia, begin and please. Choose the correct word for complete this paragraph. This daily routine. Natalia, for example here, Dr. Mary Smith likes her job very much because she loves animals. Continue,
Natalia. No, teacher, todavía no me aparece nada en la pantalla.
Los demás me dicen si están viendo la pantalla. Sebastián, Luz Kelly,
yes,
Edward.
Yes,
Natalia, ¿sí la ven? Pronto desde un celular.
Sí.
Tienes que colocarlo en modo horizontal para que puedas visualizar.
Sí, sí sale. Sí estoy viendo la pantalla.
Ok, Edward. Ok, very good. Entonces todos me van a participar acá, ¿no? Ojo acá. Entonces continuo, Luz Kelly, para avanzar.
Sería her daily routine is very different for her husband.
Yes, continue Sebastián hasta shower.
She gets up at 7:45 every day. Then she goes
Yes. Go
to the bathroom and she have a shower. She has a shower.
Continue, Luz Kelly. Luz Kelly.
Then she gets dressed and has breakfast with her family.
Breakfast. Kelly. Breakfast. Y ahora les comparto un diccionario para que se asocien con la pronunciación, la fonética.
Okay. Has breakfast with her family. Then she leaves home and goes to work by car.
Okay.
And 9 o'clock. She arrives at the veterinary clinic.
Veterinarian
clinic. During the morning, she treats.
Continue. Edward, no sé si me escucha Edward.
During the morning.
Yes.
Sí, tutora. During the morning.
During the morning, she.
Sí, sino que se me quitó la pantalla.
Oh. Sebastián, ¿me colaboras?
During the morning, she treats. Traits
animals.
In the afternoon she always operates on some animals.
Yes. Continue, Natalia. Natalia, thank you, Sebastián. Sebastián. Ah, perdón, con Natalia, please tell me. Natalia.
No me aparece nada.
Sorry, te entiendo entonces. Luz Kelly, please tell me.
At 12:30, she goes to a little restaurant and has lunch. At their lunch, she phones to her husband and I sería de.
She and Ken?
Arrives, she goes.
And then, ahí sería un conector. And then.
She goes back to the clinic. Before going back home, she does.
Before going back home, and she, aquí sería, a ver. ¿Me escuchan?
Yes,
aquí sería como un das. Perdón, aquí sería un adverbio de frecuencia, porque mira, She often goes to the gym. O sea, ella a menudo va al gimnasio. ¿Sí? Continue. She always.
She always.
Huh? Sebastián Gel ayuda a. Ayudemos a Luz Kelly, Sebastián, por favor.
Ahí sería hub. Ella siempre tiene hub.
¿Casa?
No, hub.
Sería, para mí es arise. Arise. ¿Sí? She always arrives home at 6 o'clock.
Yes, teacher.
¿Sí? She always arrives at 6 o'clock. Me disculpan, se escuchan ruido porque es que tengo un vecino muy, muy impulsivo con música todo el tiempo y me va a tocar
sí,
que hablar.
Sí, se escucha, sí.
Sí, me disculpan, sí, ¿ok? Sí, listo. Bueno, continuemos. First, Edward, ¿me puedes colaborar acá? Ya para finalizar. First.
Profe, no encuentro la pantalla, ahorita la tenía y se me perdió, no la encuentro, no sé cómo ubicarla.
Dios. Sebastián, ¿me colaboras?
Yes, teacher. Here, first, she kisses her husband. And
she kisses her husband. She kisses her husband
and children. And then she reads the newspaper before dinner. She sometimes lies the table at 8:30 they all have dinner.
Have dinner. They all have dinner.
After dinner, she wash. No, she does.
She does the washing up,
and she washes.
Yes.
TV or reads a book. Finally, she goes to the bed at midnight.
She goes to the bed at midnight. Very good. Miremos cómo nos fue. Okay, todas súper bien. Listo. Muy bien, nos vamos de acá. A ver.
Perfecto.
Exacto. Ok, uy, ¿qué pasó acá? Que me salí de una pantalla toda rara. Bueno, me voy aquí ahora a compartirles nuevamente el pantallazo. ¿Y dónde voy a compartir? Voy para la presentación. No quiere salir. Ténganme paciencia porque este está. ¿Qué pasó acá? Déjenme aquí. Ahora sí. Bueno. Me dicen si pueden ver la pantalla, ¿verdad? Bueno, aquí está el texto. Natalia, mira, aquí está el texto que nosotros trabajamos en el juego. ¿Listo? Ok, ese es el juego. Güey, pay attention. Rápidamente vamos a mirar a ver estas preguntas. What does she do, Natalia? Sebastián, perdón. What does she do? ¿Qué hace ella?
She's a veterinarian.
Yes. Yes, veterinarian. Okay. Luz Kelly, what time does she get up? Natalia? Luz Kelly, perdón.
7:45 p.m.
Every day. She get up at 7:45 every day. Okay. Natalia, pay attention. What does he do during morning? What does, perdón, she, no he, excuse me. What does she do during the morning? A ver, ¿dónde está esa información? Aquí, ya la vi. Okay. Tell me, Natalia. Natalia, ¿puedes ver la pantalla?
Yes, teacher. Okay. She gets up at 7:45 every day.
Yes. Okay, continue.
Then she goes to the bath and she has a shower. Then she gets dressed and has breakfast with her family. Then she leaves, has breakfast with her family. Then she leaves home and goes to work because at 9 o'clock she arrives at the veterinary clinic. During the morning, she treats animals.
No more. Operated. Y los opera. ¿Sí? Ok, continue. Uh-huh. Very good. Continue, Sebastián. What does she have lunch?
Lunch. She dinner. At 8:30 mm-hmm. with your family.
Okay. Listo. Well, continuo. Miren, me disculpan si escuchan mucho ruido. Yo vivo en toda la esquina de un coliseo y creo que hay un evento. Sí, entonces cualquier cosa, pues entiendan la situación. Les agradezco, ¿ok? Muchísimas gracias. Bueno, rápidamente les voy a compartir este video y aquí listen, pay attention, listen to the to a student talk about the his daily routines for answering the question 1 to 7 and choose the correct answer. Okay? Give me a moment because I share the presentation. I share the link. Okay? Uh-huh. Dejar de compartir, me vuelvo otra vez para acá y lo coloco acá. Ok. Please. Ok, pay attention. Tell me. Begin. Pay attention, ok. And listen.
My name is Fred. I live in London and I'm 17 years old. I wake up at.
Ok. Sebastian, where does Fred live? Luca, choose the correct word. In London, in New York, or in Paris? What is the correct?
In London?
Yes, very good. Okay.
I wake up at 7 and I usually get out of bed about 7:30.
Natalia, can you see or can you listen the question, yes? What time does Fred get up? wake up, excuse me. What time does Fred wake up? At 7:30, at 7:45, or at 7 o'clock? What is the correct answer?
Is 7 o'clock.
Very good. Excellent. Continue.
Then I come downstairs and have breakfast. Usually I have cereal for breakfast with orange juice, but sometimes I have toast with usually jam or honey. Then I pack my bag.
Okay. Luz Kelly, what does Fred have for breakfast? Cereal and orange juice, a cup of tea, a toast with peanut butter. What is the correct?
Cereal and orange juice.
Cereal. Cereal and orange and then orange juice. Okay, cereal. Okay.
Okay.
Bag for school. I walk because my school's only it's only in the center of the town where I live, so it's only 15 minutes walk in the morning, which is good because it means I can sleep later.
Okay. No sé si Edward me pueda colaborar. Edward, please tell me, does Fred go by bus to school? He doesn't or no, she doesn't. Oh, no, no, he doesn't, excuse me. What is? Si Edward no puede, ¿me colabora Sebastián, por favor?
Okay, teacher. No, he doesn't.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
The school is quite old. It's been a school for about 400 years, and it's got about 1,000 students there. In 7 age groups, and it's only boys there.
Okay, pay attention here, Luz Kelly. Are there girls in Fred's school? Yes, there are, or no, there aren't. What is?
No, there aren't.
No, there aren't. Very good. It's only good boys.
School starts at 8:30, and then we have two lessons, which go until 10:15. 10:45, we have break for 15 minutes. Then 11 till 12:40, we have two more lessons, and then lunchtime. I can go into town to get my lunch. But most people have to stay in the school and eat the school food. And British school food isn't very nice.
Okay. Does Fred like food at his school? And Natalia, please. No, he doesn't. Or no. Yes, he doesn't. Or no, she doesn't. Or no, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, very good. Okay.
There, we have two more lessons after lunch, and we finish school at 3:30. Usually I come home and...
Okay. Sebastian, what time does Fred's school finish? What time? At 3 o'clock, at 3:15, or at 3:30? What is?
At 3:15?
No, it's at 3:30. Okay, it's at 3:30. Okay, don't worry, Sebastian.
And I just sort of relax for a bit. And that's usually for maybe an hour. I read or I watch television. And my mom gets...
Okay, and finally, Natalia, please tell me, what does Fred do in his free time? He watches TV and reads, he paints and watches TV, he rides his bike. What is the correct answer?
No sabría decir, profe.
Okay. Luz Kelly, can you help Natalia, please?
He wants to be
and reads. Very good. Excellent.
My mom gets home about usually between 5:30 and 6:30, and so we'll usually eat dinner about 6:30.
Okay, very good. Finish in this part. In this part, pay attention. Como ya estamos pasaditos de tiempo, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Pay attention here. Vamos a omitir esta parte. Okay. Okay. Ustedes me van a decir what is your daily routine? Excuse me. No. Vamos a van a ver, volver a ver el video, look at the video, ¿sí? With subtitles. And then ask two questions. Yes? As you do, ask two questions. Yes? And this question you ask to a partner. Yes? Then the partner that you select most ask you the others two questions and you ask the answer them, ¿sí? O sea, ¿qué es lo que vamos a hacer? Ustedes arman sus preguntas de acuerdo al video. Ya se los comparto para que lo volvamos a ver. Y ustedes, pues, van a armar, de acuerdo a lo que ustedes ven en el video, pues, van a organizar no dos preguntas. Vamos a hacerlo nada más con una, ¿ok? Una sola preguntita. Y ustedes hacen una pregunta y se la hacen a un compañero. Ese compañero responde y también le hace la otra pregunta a otro compañero. Por ejemplo, empecemos con Sebastián. Sebastián pregunta a Luz Kelly. Luz Kelly responde. Luz Kelly ask the question to Natalie. Natalie answer the question. Natalie ask the question to Edward. And Edward answer the question. Yes? And so in finish. Ok. Vamos a hacerlo con una solita. Rapidito, ¿sí? Ya les vuelvo y les comparto el video, por favor. ¿Qué tenéis aquí? Espérame un segundo, si es este. ¿Sí ven la pantalla, por favor? Can you see? ¿Lo pueden ver?
My name's Fred.
Sí, okay.
I live in London and I'm 17 years old. I wake up at 7 and I usually get out of bed about 7:30. Then I come downstairs and have breakfast. Usually I have cereal for breakfast with orange juice, but sometimes I have toast with usually jam or honey. Then I pack my bag for school. I walk because my school's only in the center of the town where I live. So it's only 15 minutes walk in the morning, which is good because it means I can sleep later. The school is quite old. It's been a school for about 400 years and it's got about 1,000 students there in 7 age groups. And it's only boys there. School starts at 8:30. And then we have two lessons, which go until 10:15. 10:45 we have break for 15 minutes. Then 11 till 12:40 we have two more lessons. And then lunchtime. I can go into town to get my lunch, but most people have to stay in the school and eat the school food. And British school food isn't very nice. Then we have two more lessons after lunch and we finish school at 3:30. Usually I come home and I just sort of relax for a bit. And that's usually for maybe an hour. I read or I watch television. And my mom gets home about usually between 5:30 and 6:00. And so we'll usually eat dinner about 6:30.
Okay. Finish. Okay, please. And now you write the question. Write the question. Escriban una pregunta. And then ask the question, ¿ok? Understand me? ¿Me entienden? ¿Me entendieron el ejercicio que vamos a hacer, sí?
Yes, sí.
Ok. Okay. Beginner, Sebastián, ask the question to Kelly. Sebastián, ask the question to Kelly. Yes,
do you have a breakfast in the morning?
Repeat, please.
Do you have breakfast in the morning?
I have breakfast at 8:30 a.m.
Okay. Do you repeat again the question? The answer is Natalia. Luz Kelly, excuse me. ¿Me repites la pregunta? The answers.
I am usually 8:30 a.m.
A ver, do you have breakfast in the morning? O sea, si tú desayunas en la mañana.
Ay, excuse me. La planteé mal.
¿No? ¿O what? Sería what. What do you have breakfast in the morning? Sería la pregunta que tú querías hacerle, Sebastián.
Sí, sí, profe.
Ok, what. Te lo voy a colocar en el chat, ¿sí? What do you have breakfast in the morning? Signo de pregunta, que no se nos olvide. ¿Listo? Ok. Natalia, Luz Kelly, please answer the question fast, please.
Natalia, what time do you study?
I answer, teacher. Or...
What? And please read again the question.
What time do you study? ¿A qué hora estudias?
Sí, what time do you study, Sebastián?
Ah, okay. I study, I generally study at 7 a.m.
Okay, very good. Very good. Okay, continue. Natal, Luz Kelly, ¿sí? Natalia, Luz Kelly, ask the question. No, ¿cómo íbamos acá? Tocaría ahora hacer Natalia, Natalia le hace la pregunta a Edward, ¿sería? ¿Sí? Hagamos eso.
Yes, okay. Teacher.
What time do you get up?
Get up.
Get up.
What time do you get up? What time do you get up? Edward, answer the question. Edward se salió. ¿O Eduard está en clase? No.
What time? Pregunta, ¿qué tiempo, qué? ¿Qué hora?
What time do you get up? What time do you get up?
7. What time?
Entonces, I get up, se va, Edward, repite again, I get up. I get up.
7.
At, la preposición de tiempo. I get up at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock.
Okay,
very good. At 7 o'clock.
Okay. Okay, well, pay attention here. In this moment, each student say his daily routines and interests about once, first, minute or more. ¿Ustedes qué van a hacer? Cada uno va a decir su rutina diaria, pero me la va a tratar de decir en un minuto. Si pasa, de tiempo mucho mejor, ¿ok? Entonces, ojo con eso. Pero como ya estamos pasaditos de tiempo, hagámosle con un minuto. ¿Yes? Entonces, empecemos. ¿Quién quiere empezar? Rapidito, por favor. Colabórenme ahí. No quiero cogerlos con los calzoncitos abajo, de sorpresa.
I'm beginning, teacher.
Bueno, teacher.
Okay, okay. Continue. You, Sebastian, begin and follow Luz Kelly, after Natalia, and finally Edward. Okay. Beginner, Sebastian.
I get up at 6 a.m. and then and I take a shower to. At 7 a.m. and then generally and usually to eat the breakfast to 7:30 a.m. and finally then study at 8 a.m. and finish to 12 p.m.
Okay, very good. Stop.